Welcome to the latest entertainment news analysis show on the planet. This is Tea Time on Plus TV Africa, and I am Ife Oluwa Osunke, and I'm here with a smart and intelligent Ife Omai. Today is the World Environment Day, so ensure you look after your environment, keep it clean, and keep it safe.
You never give me compliments like that. What did I do something nice?
You said something smart, a little bit smart today.
Okay, I'll take it.
How you doing though?
I'm well. How
How's
are
your
you?
Day been?
Good, but I'm excited that it's almost done. I cannot wait for the weekend, fam.
What are your plans for the weekend?
To go just sit down and recover.
My
tummy is not settled. I don't know what it is that I'm eating in this Lagos, but I just need a detox and be spoiled and not
and
wake up early.
We hope you really get your recovery because we need you back here on Monday.
Of course, I'll be here.
All right, so let's get into the business of the day, right? Mm-hmm. All right, so first off, Forbes has released the world's highest paid celebrities, and Kylie Jenner tops world's highest paid celebrity list just a week after Forbes reports that she has been yanked off the billionaire list. And the world's highest paid celebrities earned a combined $6.1 billion before taxes and fees, a $200 million drop from 2019 after the global pandemic shuttered stadiums and silenced performances around the world. Number two on this list is Kanye West with 170 million. Wow, that's a gap. Mm-hmm. And number three is Roger Federer, which $106.3 million. The outlet drew its ranking from the pre-tax earnings of front of the camera stars across the world between June 2019 and May 2020, before deducting fees for managers, lawyers, and agents. These guys are really making money, because if you're deducting money for managers, tax, lawyers, come on.
And you're still making that much.
Like,
I mean, the obsession with having knowing what people earn and what people own is kind of cringe, but it's interesting. It's still a very interesting conversation to have, especially with Kylie and the gap that she's giving these people. Like, it's a lot of money.
It's a lot.
I'm impressed by that. I don't know how she's able to do that, because there must be something else.
I'm glad you're saying this, because we wouldn't say she bought her way this time. 590 million, sorry, we wouldn't say she bought her way into this. Or she's,
I'm not saying that she doesn't have privilege. I feel like everyone,
yeah, she has privilege, but she's still cashing out for real. That is, her business is actually booming.
So privilege doesn't let you cash out for real. Please, I'm not taking back anything I've said about Kylie, but what I wanted to say on top of what I've said is that there's definitely more to it than the Kardashian factor, because I know a lot of the people that I roam around with personally are not Kardashian fans. And what we see that we don't like is the Kardashian effect, and I think there's more to that about this girl, because she's the only Kardashian on that list, and they all are known for the same thing. And so there's something else that she's doing, and all the sisters have businesses and stuff, so there's something else that she's doing.
I think she chose the right line of business, if you ask me, because that's something that is actually booming right now.
Clothes is booming. Kim and Courtney have had their dash.
Yeah, but are they that big for their clothes line to move that much?
We would argue the same thing about
People like Jay-Z with Rockefeller. How many people do you see rocking Rockefeller?
Well, people are arguing that. How many people do you see wearing Kylie cosmetics, except from YouTubers? It's all over the internet. That's why people don't understand where her money is coming from. She must tell us, Sha. Want to learn.
Man, she's making that money. Keep it up, girl, because I'm really impressed, because I'm just barely a week after the yanked her off the Forbes list for being a billionaire.
It's a good backlash.
She came back stronger, and they can't even help this, because they could have been like, oh, no, we don't have to put Kylie on because we have bad blood. But we don't know about the relationship, even though she called them out saying that she thought they were
a reputable
platform and all of that. But we don't know if they have bad blood personally. We don't know what they said behind the prints now, because we're going to say behind the camera. So behind the prints, we don't know what they've said to each other. So this is a good comeback. And for all the haters out there that are like, so she lied. She just lied by 100 million. Just 100 million.
Just
100 million. She's just 100 million short of being a billionaire. Yeah. Man. Just 100. Come on, you have that now.
Amen.
All right, so congratulations to Kylie Jenner. And on that list, we have people like Cristiano Ronaldo, who just became a billionaire as well. And I think he's the second billionaire after Floyd Mayweather in the football world. Mm. And I think he's on number four on that list. And we have Messi on number five. So the athletes are really going.
Yeah.
And Federer as well is also a tennis player, and he comes in at number three. So congratulations to all of them. And I hope I'll be on that list soon, right?
I thought it's a hustle.
Hustle, make you no good, they read news. All right, so on the next topic is on Corey Debiello, who has revealed the kind of partner he wants. He wrote on Twitter, "I'm more concerned about intellectual and emotional compatibility in a relationship than I am about sexual compatibility." Man, they all come together, if you ask me. But
I think I would have said emotional, intellectual, and sexual.
You understand?
I can't put... I'm sorry. I don't care how much intellectual...
If
and
the sex isn't...
There has to be that for me. For me, personally, it's very important. But it's... I mean, to each man his own. And I like that he still puts intellectual first. Because the thing about sexuality is that for it not to be compatible, there must be something really, really, like, off there. Because usually you can learn to, you know each other and be more compatible. But it's harder, much harder, to be able to get that with the intellect or with emotions, because a lot of that is influenced by how you were raised, the kind of personality you have, which is hard to change. Mm-hmm. But it's easier to learn someone's body. So I agree to him if that is the logic. But if he's minimizing the importance of sexual compatibility, then I disagree.
Remember when we had that conversation about the rural girl and the urban girl,
yeah,
which one would you go for? And I said, it depends on who I can connect with mentally, because you have to be intellectually sound. If I have that connection with you, then I really don't care where you're from, whether you're from the village, as long as we can connect intellectually. But at the end of the day, the sex is also paramount. Like, it is important, because that's the only way I can stay faithful. That's the only way I can stay faithful.
Even so, when your wife is pregnant, what's gonna happen? I'm pregnant to a point where
did
she
they
can't
say pregnant
sex.
Women can
pregnant
have sex?
To a point where she can't have sex.
Come on, I can stay up and celebrate for a while now.
So you know what I'm saying?
I'm just saying that it's important. That is, if we're talking about a marriage, a relationship, that you have long-term plans for, the sex is equally important. You can't just focus on the emotional, intellectual, but that comes first for me as well. The intellectual connection, the emotional connection comes before the sex, but don't undermine the sex. The sex is really, really
important.
Yeah,
and I think a lot of conversations that happen in this part of the world is always trying to tell you that it's not important. I know that they preach that a lot in church as well, that when people bring up their worries, I remember sitting in one youth something, and a lady asked, "But what if I wait and I get there and I don't..." You know that normal conversation every Christian girl has had, and you don't like what you and say you should learn.
But
and
how would you
like
know
that.
What you're supposed to like if you waited along? That's always the next question to all of that.
That what?
How would you know what you like or what you're not supposed to like if you waited?
No,
all
I'm
along.
Sure you know what you don't like. If you're are you robots?
You don't have varieties, so the first one you get should be the only one you like. Like, what is wrong with you? What else you get to like?
I guess, but
you know the ones that with that problem are the ones that they've had variety. They're like, I like
this. No, but sometimes you might.
Have
you not ever tasted something and you just, even if you don't like, you eat pasta for the first time and you're like, yeah, this is not great. Like, even for, you might not have anything else to compare it to, but sometimes you just know when something is just not up to it. And like I said before, it's not even just about performances or things like that, because I think you can learn all those things. When I hear things like I don't know why I focus so much on sexuality, but when I hear things like sexual not being compatible sexually, I'm talking like maybe sizes now, like things that you can't actually change. That's what we are talking
about. How would you know a size that you prefer? The size you get is what you should get.
Based on satisfaction. You don't have to know that you're not, that you, without going somewhere else, you know that you're not satisfied. You just,
true
you
that.
You would know.
True that. Okay. All right, so,
enough of sexuality, please. This is my
topic. All right, so, we hope Corey Debiello finds what he's looking for.
Yeah.
Intellectual and emotional. You don't have to be great in bed, okay? So, just holler at Corey Debiello. So, another Instagram user says men are not strong enough to handle the sexual past of a woman, and she goes by the handle @_oasis.
I I think she needs to change the type of men that she is around. There is definitely truth in that. I have seen people who have very vivid and strong ideas of what they want their woman, their it woman to be. And they're usually very backward, in my opinion. They like them to be untouched and pure, and they use weird words like that. So I agree to what she's saying, but for her to generalize that and then say that all men can handle you being like that, I think she just needs to change her circle. There is a big world out there.
I don't think she really needs to change it, because there's a bit of truth in what she's saying. Look, if I'm in a relationship with a woman, and then today she tells me about, this is how this person A, she tells me about B, she tells me about C, she tells me about D, she tells me about E, and then we're getting close to Z. Come on, I'll start having problems. Like,
why? What, your ego can't handle it?
And it's not like my ego can't handle it. It just gives me a different perception of
that
you.
What, that she's had a life before you?
She's had a life before, but not that type of life. Not the life I envisage for somebody I want to spend the rest of my life with.
What's wrong with having a
partner? There's absolutely nothing wrong with it, but you know what? It's a different thing if it all started and then from the onset, maybe before it gets too deep, I have this information. But don't spring it up on me from time to time. Don't start telling me about your sexual experiences.
Well, you can't know everything about a woman. And it's not as if your first date, you'd be like, hi, my name is Ife and I've slept with like 500 people before.
In the first month, 2 months, I deserve to know, three months.
Things will still come up in conversation. Even if you know my body count and you know everything, there's sometimes I will be like, oh yeah, this happened with Z, or this happened with H. You're going to be uncomfortable when that happens.
Well, for me though, I like to ask certain questions so that I can just, you know, improve and be better. so I can keep getting better and better and better. But no, seriously, I like to ask questions like,
just I think if you have a problem with this, you need to really some men just, personal opinion here, some men just have very small, I guess, their egos just feel really threatened by a woman who's had experience. Because I think
experience
it's very,
is different from experiences.
You're not serious.
Trust me.
But would you have a problem? Don't you have past Ife?
I do, but I think I'll let a woman know.
She's supposed to be okay with that, but you're not going to be okay with
your
woman.
Well, maybe because I'm the type of guy that maybe in the first 3 months I would ask you. So I think the problem comes with the guys too that don't ask the right questions.
So yours is not about the information. Yours is about the timeline.
Yeah, it's about the timeline.
Oh, okay. No, I don't.
All right. So we need to go on a break, but tea time continues right after this break.